Reportedly, believers by the thousands journey to Venezuela to seek the blessings of a visionary. The sick come in need of healing. Others may hope to witness a miracle. Visionary Maria Esperanza appears to be the vortex for a whirlwind of supernatural events. Deep within the forests of Venezuela lives a woman who claims to see apparitions of the Virgin Mary. Maria Esperanza is a wife, a mother, and grandmother, and by some accounts, touched by the divine. Producer-director Drew Mariani.
She's a prophet. She's a healer. She has the gift of bilocation, the ability to read souls.
Author Michael Brown.
If half of what they say about her is true, she's one of the major mystics, not just of our time, but of any time this century. A woman who has prophesied on any number of occasions events that have taken place in exactly the fashion she said.
On one occasion, she had prophesied to a group of pilgrims standing there. She saw two very large towers in a city, and she feared for what was to happen to these towers. A few weeks later, the bombing of the Twin Trade Towers took place. She has prophesied the deaths of the past three popes. I was in her presence during one apparition where she saw a terrible earthquake take place. About a month later, she described it to me. During the World Series, an earthquake rocked California.
Maria claims visitations of heavenly beings began at an early age.
Her first apparition took place when she was age five. At age 14, St. Teresa the Little Flower appeared to her, a brilliantly red rose, and she threw this rose to Esperanza. Instead of catching the rose, something pricked her right hand, and it began to bleed. And this was the onset of the stigmata.
As an adult, these alleged supernatural manifestations were to be witnessed by many.
Blood will erupt on her palms while she's praying the Stations of the Cross on Good Fridays. On one occasion, two doctors accompanied her and actually were there when the blood started to come from her hands. They weren't able to explain it.
Her son-in-law one day saw Maria kneeling in prayer. Suddenly her head went back, she stuck her tongue out, and before his eyes, a host materialized on her tongue. The bishop himself has witnessed such phenomena.
One of the most remarkable testimonies come from her children. One of her daughters said that she saw a light reflect on her mother, and her mother rose in levitation, her feet actually off the ground at that time.
All sorts of phenomena takes place. A mysterious fog that appears out of nowhere. Rose petals fall from the sky. The odor of roses are said to surround her. She's a woman that has blessed with many mystical gifts and charisms.
Of all her alleged gifts involving roses, one phenomenon is truly unbelievable.
It's just bizarre. I mean, it really is an incredible phenomenon. It's very, very hard to accept. The presence of medical doctors who have written, sworn testimony to what they've seen. A budded rose came through her chest and opened up. It was a brilliant, beautiful red, even touched with dew, almost as if though it was freshly picked.
Drew Mariani claims a personal encounter with Maria's supernatural gifts. Reportedly, it happened during a video interview that he conducted with Maria at her home in Venezuela. He witnessed a bilocation, a being in two places at the same time.
Many people have reported seeing Maria in one place when in fact she was in another. During the taping of an interview with Maria, I had asked her a question and had asked her to pray for a person I had known who was in a very severe car accident.
Maria. This isn't really part of our interview, but I have a question. It's about a friend.
Yes.
He's back in the States. He was in a bad car accident, and he's paralyzed.
I will go to him. Where does he live?
5, maybe 10 kilometers from my home.
Please, stop your camera. You will have a problem with your tape.
Keep rolling.
Your friend is in a dark room. He is drinking some tea. And he is wearing a blue shirt. I am taking his hand and I am lifting him up.
When this incident was over, my cameraman was very skeptical that anything at all had happened. So when we got back to the hotel room, we called to the United States, called that person, and to his surprise as well as mine, described in detail exactly what he was wearing and exactly what had happened.
One of the extraordinary gifts that the Virgin Mary reportedly bestowed upon Maria Esperanza, the gift of healing, may have been witnessed by a young couple who gave birth to a very sick child named Ryan.
Gave birth to a little boy. Our sonograms were normal. And we had a big surprise. The little boy came out with spina bifida myelomeningocele.
At the base of his spine, in the center, was his spinal cord, open like an open book, exposed to the air.
I was devastated, really devastated. To see that little boy, and then not knowing, you know, would he walk? You know, what kind of a life would he have?
Medical doctors offered little hope, so the Hulicks went searching for a miracle.
Here I had this little boy with all of these complications, and I wanted to go and hopefully see Maria Esperanza, ask for her prayers and her advice, and then take it from there.
Ryan was 2 years old when the Hulicks made the pilgrimage to Venezuela in search of a cure. During the long bus ride into the countryside, the Hulicks met a family therapist named Marilyn Bakeland.
What I saw was a very placid, sweet little child of 23 months who obviously had spina bifida. He wasn't moving. His eyes were not focused, slightly crossed eyes. Right away I'm thinking, this was the trip that was going to cure their baby. They had such faith in this. I thought, oh, I hope they're not disappointed.
When they reached the Esperanza home, the Hulicks joined with the throngs of hopeful pilgrims. Waiting for them was an urgent message from Maria.
Mother Esperanza knew we were there. She said to her daughter, tell them that already I'm sending out my assistance to them, and that already all of his cells are changing, his blood is changing, the bones are changing, everything is already beginning.
The hour had come when Maria Esperanza was to take little Ryan into her arms.
She took him and she prayed with him and she ran her hand all over him. And I realized that Jesus had already begun the healing before she even touched him. She said he's been set free at last, set free.
It was on the bus ride home that the Hulicks claimed to have witnessed a miracle.
We were on the bus going back to Caracas, and Ryan immediately showed a much increased strength. It was totally amazing.
It was as if someone had waved this magic wand, and this baby went from a retarded, placid baby to a normal two-year-old. There wasn't any doubt in my mind. This baby was cured.
You could see it in his eyes that he had just been set free from this condition that he had been born with. And within the shortest amount of time of coming home, he was walking. And now he's just all over the place. He's doing great.
Of all the gifts Maria Esperanza claims the Virgin Mary has given her, the most profound is perhaps the gift of prophecy. Because Maria says the Virgin has issued warnings for the future of mankind.
The Virgin has told Maria this is the hour of decision for mankind, that a very serious moment is approaching soon. She fears that we are on the doorstep of a global war. When you least expect it, be very careful, for she fears that the Soviet Union may try some sort of attack.
She warns about new diseases and plagues that will kill in a matter of days instead of a matter of years. And we are at a serious turning point. He says we face a lot of turmoil and perhaps catastrophic events, but in the end, the world will be a better place and it'll be a great spiritual reawakening.